But I'm at this crucial point in my life that, well, it's like I'm 35, and I feel like my body has started to decay, but my brain is starting to regress into adolescence. Tell me this isn't a bad sign for my future. Last week, I hurt my back playing video games. It's kind of a nut slap from God, right? When you're playing Madden and you kick a field goal and you're like, to the right, oh, that's not good. Like, that doesn't fill you with confidence about your future. It's all I do in my free time is play video games. I'm a PlayStation man myself. PlayStation people? Okay. Xbox. Let me explain this to people who don't know much about video games. There's PlayStation and Xbox, which are like the Crips and the Bloods of the nerd worlds. For you older folks, the Sharks and the Jets. That's the stuff I know. When you're a Jet, kickball change, kickball change. You get the point. But the problem is, they're rivals. PlayStation and Xbox, they're mortal enemies, but there's a respect between the two of them as long as you're not one of the Wii assholes. No, I'm sorry. No. No. If I wanted to move around, I would leave my apartment, okay? I don't need to waste energy doing that. That's my Doritos hand. I need that free. Like, if PlayStation and Xbox are the Crips and the Bloods, Wii is like whatever gang Sha-Na-Na was in. It's a much lamer gang. I can see I've left a few people in the dust. I apologize about that. Not everyone's on board. Some people think video games are juvenile and immature. Be honest with me. Who here thinks video games are juvenile? Anybody?
I do.
Oh, you do? Okay. Oh, that's great. No, it's perfectly fine. Just one more question for you, sir. How does it feel to be so completely fucking wrong? Is that awkward at all for you? To be so back-asswards? The only reason you think video games are immature is that they haven't always existed. They've only been around 25, 30 years. It's not always going to be like that. As we get older, so will video games. In fact, I am in the first generation of Americans who are going to be 90 years old in rest homes, like, fucking die, In fact, that's how I'm going to go. I'm going to be in a rocking chair playing Guitar Hero 28 on expert level, like, victory, just flatline right there. With a smile on my face and carpal tunnel in my wrist. The elderly love video games. They just don't know it yet. Because just think about this. What do old people do for fun left to their own devices? They go to casinos, they play the slot machines. And what are slot machines other than piss poor video games? An old person sits down, presses a button, goes, cherry, cherry, oh, lemon, game over. That's just a shitty game is all that is. That is sub-Donkey Kong bullcrap is what that is. And you have no idea what you are capable of, man. I'm telling you, video games give you a sense of accomplishment that the real world does not provide. Because the games I like to play, like Medal of Honor, Splinter Cell, Grand Theft Auto, you get to go on missions. That's right, fuckers, missions. When's the last time you went on a mission? Never. Oh, I got a promotion last year. Well, yesterday, I freed the fucking princess. So who had a bigger day? Who had a bigger day? This guy, that's who. Numero un. And I'm Super Bowl MVP, so suck on that. And you have no concept of what you are capable of emotionally if you do not play video games. You have a reservoir of passion that you have never learned to access. Until you've had one of those nights where you've been playing the same game and you've been killed 22 times in a row trying to complete that same mission. And now the sun is beginning to rise. The birds are starting to chirp. You have to be at work in 4 hours. Your hands are sweaty. Your eyes are watering because you're afraid to fucking blink. You know what I mean? You know when you get close to the end, you start to hyperventilate? You're like, oh my God, I'm gonna do it. Oh my God, I'm gonna do it. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. And when that moment comes where you complete that mission, emotion just pours down over you. A choir of angels singing. It is as good as any orgasm. You know what? It's better because there's no cleanup. That's how good it is. That's right. That's how good it is. It is a jizz fest without ruining your favorite t-shirt. Gloria, hallelujah, and Excelsis Deo. Is that too vivid there at the end? Probably didn't need the t-shirt part, did I? I'm not saying it doesn't go too far. Did you ever get so angry playing a game that you threw the controller at the TV? Isn't it amazing how quickly that snaps you back into reality? It's like instantaneous. I'll feel like an idiot before the controller has even left my hands. I'm like, fuck this game, this is bullshit. Oh, this is a mistake. I'm gonna have some explaining to do. 5 seconds later, the controller's in pieces, my wife's out of bed, furious, and I'm trying to explain myself to her as if there's any rational excuse for that behavior. Hey, honey, do not get mad at me. You have no idea how close I was to acquiring the Sword of Destiny. Sound like a jackass. Say one more thing about this. I just wish that my marriage operated more like a video game does, right? Because relationships are confusing. In a video game, you know exactly where you stand, right? Like, I'm the good guy, you're the bad guy, we're gonna fight, one of us will die. But at least afterwards, ladies, that argument will be over. You see how that works, women? There's closure in a video game. Because anyone here in a long-term relationship knows that arguments do not end. Not important arguments. No. They just go into remission for a while, only to flare up again unexpectedly at a later date. Yeah, every couple has those top 5 greatest hit arguments that you'll just kind of dust off when you have a few minutes to kill, right? Like, oh, look, we have 5 minutes. Let's ruin the fucking evening. Yeah. And you'll bring up something that happened like 3 years ago and just pick up where you left off. And you'll argue for a while until something interrupts you and you kind of put it back down on hold again. You'd be like, no, wrong. Oh, look, the movie's about to start. Then it goes underground again for another 7 or 8 weeks until a night comes along where my wife has had 1 too many vodka gimlets. Somebody in the room is stupid enough to say the word Salma Hayek and now it's fucking on again. Now we're fighting about my internet history. Brrr. I can see that struck a chord with a few people. Damn you, Mr. Skin. My point is, it wouldn't go down like that in a video game, right? If that argument happened in, say, Mortal Kombat, we'd get things settled once and for all. But apparently, if I rip my wife's spine out of her back and hold it above my head in triumph while she collapses in a fleshy heap, society shuns that sort of behavior.